this group is to provide all students of all ages with the tools necessary to deal with issues associated with drunk driving. And for the last year, we've got Teens Drunk Driving, as the name suggests. This organization shows that many teens are committed to putting an end to drunk driving.
Steps you guys can take. You can volunteer, join the Army of Civilians at Mothers Against Drunk Driving, who will become great activists to help save lives and prevent injuries caused by impaired drivers. You can take action, send a personalized letter to the state legislator about the issues important to you, or you can donate in West St. Paul, where there's a Mothers Against Drunk Driving station or whatever. You can donate to prevent to the prevention of drunk driving.
So if you take your training and you can't drive, you can get these apps that help you. You can Uber, or that says, and a BAC tracker.
Determinants that lead to drunk driving: neighborhood poverty or deprivation, overconfidence in their own driving skills for driving. Drunk driving laws or being in high school and college.
Solutions for some of these could be cheap jobs or shelters for the homeless people. That could also have strict rules on drinking and something like that, so that they wouldn't be able to go out and buy alcohol with what little money they have. Bars or places like that could have blood alcohol concentration testers at their exits to determine if you're too drunk to drive home or not, and then if you are, they immediately call you a cab or something like that. Or we could start installing them in every, it would be difficult, but we could start installing them in every car, and the car won't start unless you're under the legal limit. And you could avoid the wrong crowds of people in high school or college that could end up bringing you into parties where you would end up drinking. And then we could further enforce the laws that are already in place, but also we could increase the punishment level so that it would probably discourage a good portion of the population from drinking right before they're driving.
If you have not submitted a question, go ahead and do so real quick. We're just missing a few of you. We've got almost everybody on there. Of your four solutions, which one do you guys think is the best idea?
I think it has to do with the crowd you hang around with, because even if you've never touched alcohol in your life and then you start hanging out with people that are constantly drinking, eventually you'll give in to the indirect peer pressure and want to try one for yourself. Now maybe you hate it, maybe you won't drink, but there's also a great chance that you think it's cool or you want to be like your peers, and then you'd probably end up start drinking as well. So I think it's all about the crowd you're part of. It really determines whether or not you make these stupid choices.
Cool.
What was the question again?
Which of the four, which solution do you think is best?
Yeah, I agree with that. I feel like the type of people you hang around affects like what you do.
I probably agree with the one where like you're at the bar, because once you're at the bar with friends, and then once you get intoxicated, you know, your decisions, like what decision demeanor lowers, so you don't know what you really want to do. So then you mess around and like drunk drive, and you regret it, but you won't really like know that you shouldn't have done it because you're drunk.
What measures do you think Eastview specifically could do to help teens make better decisions with drinking and driving?
Raise awareness. Maybe make it a unit in a certain class, like one of the three wellness courses. It could be a unit where you learn about drunk driving and why it's a really stupid decision. Because it's like I said earlier, usually the drunk driver isn't the one that gets hurt in the crash. It's the person that was doing everything right that ends up getting either killed or severely injured.
How about you guys? said that South Africa was the highest drinking and driving. They didn't say any things about
any explanation. It's just the highest one.
Okay.
I still think it's very surprising how much higher it is than the rest. I think Canada only went up to like 34%, South Africa was 58%. It was.
What do you feel is the most important thing that you learned personally when you were doing the research for this topic? Something that'll stick with you?
There's a lot of people that drive drunk every day, but only a certain few of them get caught.
Yeah, going off that, I feel like there's so many people out there that do it, but only a small fraction amount of people get caught.
I think it was pretty interesting to learn about how devastating certain crashes can be, depending on the circumstances, because when I was interviewing, I didn't expect, I knew his worst crash, my uncle's worst crash that he ever had to deal with would be bad, but I wasn't expecting it to be 4 dead kids in the back of a minivan.
Double clap on 3, 1, 2, 3. All right, at your table, two things that you thought they did well and two suggestions you would give them if they were to do this presentation again. Discuss.
Thank you.